Well, entering this property is like walking through a window. First things first, if I were to own this, I would get rid of all the windows and doors and replace it with something much more in keeping with the building, because look what's on the inside. It's stunning. You've got these lovely period beams, an inglenook fireplace with a beautiful grate at the back. I mean, this must be a couple of hundred years old. It's absolutely gorgeous and could be so homely. Now, the back of the property has got a completely different feel to it. Much more modern. It's obviously an extension. There are no gorgeous features, but something that I have to show you. Look at the size of this window. That is an opening. Wow! I mean, look at that. So, straight away, you want to think about restructuring this room. Now, come through here and look at this kitchen. I'm getting a little bit excited because I'm thinking, what about knocking through this wall? Again, you've got another great big window area with fantastic views. You could perhaps have lovely bifolding doors going all the way across, having a much bigger kitchen. Now, that has got me excited.
Just off the kitchen is the old lobby and another lovely feature. Upstairs, there's a very dingy and dated bathroom, but there's four double bedrooms. It's a lot of work, but my, this is spacious accommodation.
Came across a place in the middle of nowhere with a big black horse and a cherry tree.
Next to the house are some very dilapidated stables, which look to be in need of some serious structural attention. Next to those is the outdoor arena, filled with a sort of textured rubbered flooring to cushion the horses' hooves. That wouldn't have been cheap to build, although it pales into insignificance when you check out the monster indoor arena opposite.
Just look at this space! This is, in fact, an international-sized arena, and it's more than just somewhere for horse-mad kids to trot around at the weekend. This is a competition-sized structure and as big as it gets in horsey terms. And it's a considerable investment. You can't just throw up a barn and hope for the best. To build something like this, you're probably looking in excess of $100,000.
This is one expensive, super large shed, probably with its own special flooring, extra fine sand and carefully levelled floor, not to mention the bar and clubhouse on the side. The more I see of this place, the more I'm staggered by its scale. Around the back of the indoor arena, you have a large tarmacked area and further land, which belongs to the lot, but which the neighbours have access to. And opposite the main house, you have student accommodation with five dorms and living quarters. And then there's more. Yes, more stables! Are there enough horse owners around here to offer a viable livery service? Oh, I don't know, but would this property have to be a commercial enterprise?
I think the value and the appeal here lies in the combination of the house and the fact you can keep your horses by your back door. That's many people's dream, to just pop out before work and again in the evening, no travelling, loads of time to ride and just look after your animals. Perfect. And for that reason, I think it's pretty special, don't you?
OK, so it all needs some work, but if you wanted to get this place up and running as a business again, all the component parts are there. Oh, and a potentially lovely home to live in as well.
This is an extremely interesting proposition. You could reopen this place as a business, stable your own horses, run a small livery, or just keep some livestock. It's some people's dream.
This large lot sold at the guide price of £460,000 to courier Colin and cardiac nurse Shirley. So, after finally tying the knot in Vegas, we are back 7 months later to see if the newlyweds have taken it just as slowly renovating their new home. I'm pleased to say that they've got even more to celebrate. Wow, 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 wow. A beautiful new home. Wow, 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 wow. With a fabulous new kitchen dining space. Wow, 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 wow. And if you like that, Wait till you see what they've done with the front room. It looks fantastic. All the windows and doors have been replaced throughout, as the wiring has, the plumbing, and of course everything has just been redecorated. Just take a look though at the new bathroom upstairs.
Upstairs has transformed, made the bathroom bigger, took the little toilet out and made that our ensuite off of our room. And we've now got the dressing room, which isn't quite finished yet. And then just decorated the other bedrooms once the new windows were in.
It really is a top job throughout. Stylish finish with a homely feel. And downstairs, they've also managed to give the office space a new lease of life. But it's the kitchen diner that really catches your eye. Let's find out more.
OK, so the first thing we wanted to do was to bring these two rooms together. And we took down this wall, which had the fireplaces. And doing so, we now ended up with a big, large kitchen with my island. And then also that gave us a large dining room. And because we've got a big family, they now all come down and we all enjoy ourselves.
They've certainly been enjoying themselves with the fixtures and fittings here. They all look great quality. That also means they must probably be quite expensive. So, how's the budget looking?
Shirley's kept a book on all the expenditures from day one, and she surprised me the other day telling me that I was...
Well, it's about £52,000 we've spent, which is good because it leaves us... We've still got budget to sort the outside out. But yeah, without furniture and stuff that we've bought, it's about 52 on the decorating and work that's been done inside.
So I'm pleased. Well below budget.